First, we will focus on the chapter limits. Let's try to understand the concept of limit. Now, basically, we study limits of functions. So, if I consider a function, say y equal to f of x. Here, the variable x is the independent variable and f of x or y depends on it. So, where x moves, accordingly f of x will move. So, where f of x is moving, whenever x is approaching certain number is called what? The limit of the function. So, when x approaches a, to which number f of x approaches, if this function f of x approaches the number L, then we say that L is the limit of the function f of x whenever x is very close to A, or we say that x tends to A, and we express that mathematically as by writing before the function f of x the word lim. Lim means limit. Limit of this function as x tends to A, and this f of x is approaching the number L, so this L becomes the limit of this function. Now, let us see one example first of all. First, we try to understand the meaning of x tends to A. Here, A is constant and x is a variable. So, x takes different values, but this variable x is taking the values which are very close to A without taking the value A, then we say that x tends to A. For example, on this real line, suppose if I consider a number 2 and x is coming from this direction towards what? 2. So, its values could be 1.9, next value would be 1.99, next value would be what? 1.999, etc. So, whenever x is coming very close to 2 from the left or from the right. Suppose x is coming towards 2 from its right. So, values of x may be what? Say 2.1, or if it is coming still closer, then we say that 2.01, or if we write 2.000001. So, this number is very close to 2. So, whenever x is not equal to 2 and x is in the neighborhood of x equal to 2, then we say that x tends to 2, and mathematically we express this filling as x tends to 2. So, x tends to 2 means what? X is very close to 2 from either this side or this side, and x is not equal to 2. So, x tends to A means x is in the neighborhood of A, but x is not equal to A. Now, whenever x is coming close to 2 from its left, we express that as limit x tends to A minus. This minus sign indicates that x is approaching A from the left of A. So, minus sign means what? Left of A. And when I write x tends to A plus, that means x is approaching A from its right. So, here this is 2 and this is, these are the numbers which are very close to 2, but all the numbers are greater than 2. So, we express this filling by writing mathematically x tends to what? 2 plus. So, x tends to 2 plus means x approaches 2 from its right, and x tends to 2 minus means x is approaching 2 from its left. So, when I say x tends to 2, then it either means x tends to 2 plus or x tends to what? 2 minus. Now, what we are going to study is this function f of x depends on this x, and x is approaching certain number, say 2 plus, sorry, x is approaching number what? 2. Then, what is the behavior of this function f of x whenever x is tending to 2? Means, to which number this f of x is approaching when x is approaching 2 from either side of 2. So, finding that behavior means discussing the problem of the limit whenever x tends to what? A. So, limit of f of x as x tends to A equal to L essentially means difference between f of x and L is a very small number whenever x is very close to what? A. This idea can be discussed as follows. Suppose if I consider a circle and let us inscribe inside this circle a regular polygon of suppose n sides. Suppose initially n is 4. So let me choose 4 points to form a square here. So this square is inscribed in the circle of radius say r. So area of this circle, suppose this is a, equal to pi r square. Now if you try to find the area of this circle, suppose the side is a, then area of this circle is what? A square. So we see there is a big difference between the area of the circle and the area of the square. But now if I choose instead of 4 points, say 8 points. So this is now a regular polygon of 8 sides. So if I join this, I get this is a polygon whose area is comparatively bigger than the area of the square, and it is now very close to what? The area of the circle. Again, if I increase the number of sides of this polygon and if I join simply these points, so whatever area of this polygon we find, it is more than the area of what? The second one. And it is very close to what? More close to what? The area of what? The circle. So as we increase the number of sides of the polygon inside, which is inscribed in the circle, its area is approaching the area of what? The circle. So this is the concept of what? The limit. So as we increase the number of sides of the polygon which is inscribed in the circle, area of that circle is increasing, expanding, and that area is going very close to what? The area of the circle. So that is approximating the area of what? The circle. So we may say that this A equal to pi r squared could be the limit of the area of what? This polygon whenever the number of sides of that polygon increases indefinitely. So limit of f of x as x tends to A means f of x is approaching the number L whenever x is approaching the number A. Let's define this mathematically by taking certain examples also. Now let me consider a function which is defined as follows. Suppose my function f of x is say 2 plus x whenever x is less than 0, and this is equal to say 2 minus x square whenever x is greater than or equal to 0. We know that f of x equal to 2 plus x means y equal to 2 plus x is a straight line which has slope 1 and y intercept equal to 2. But that is defined only when x is what? Negative. Whenever x is positive, my function f of x is defined by some another rule, 2 minus x square. Y equal to minus x square is a parabola going in the downward direction and 2 is being added. So graph is lifted up by 2 units. So one can draw the figure of this. So if you want to draw the figure of this or the graph of this, this is your y axis, this is your x axis. Suppose this is distance 1, this is distance what? 2. This is distance 1, this is distance 2. So, y equal to 2 plus x. I am going to discuss the behavior of the function f of x in the neighborhood of the point x equal to 0. For that, I am drawing the graph, and using graph, we are trying to see the concept of limit. Y equal to 2 plus x is a straight line. When y becomes 0, x becomes minus 2. When x becomes 0, y becomes 2. So, this is the straight line. I am not extending this, because moment I extend this, for these values of x, this straight line is there. But for these values of x, means for positive values of x, my rule is different, which is 2 minus x square. So, I am restricted to what? Only what? Negative values of x as far as y equal to 2 plus x is concerned. So, this graph will not be there. Even the end point 2 is also not there, because this is defined for x less than 0. Moment I choose x equal to 0, then I would get over here 2 plus 0 equal to what? 2. But this point is missing there. We are not taking the value of x equal to 0 in this case. Now, we know the graph of y equal to 2 minus x square. Y equal to minus x square is of this form. But 2 is being added. So, this graph is lifted up by 2 units. So, it would go up to this, and I would get a parabola, but it is defined only for what? X greater than or equal to 0. Hence, it would come like this. So, this is y equal to 2 plus x, and this is y equal to 2 minus x square. So, on one side of the origin, you have a parabola, and on the left side of the origin, you have a straight line. Now, I want to discuss the limit of the function, that is the behavior of the function in the neighborhood of x equal to 0. So, suppose the values of x are coming in this direction towards what? The point 0 or the origin, the number O, 0. Now, when x takes these values, you see that these are the values of y. So, when x moves towards the origin, f of x is moving in this direction, and that is approaching this number, which is 2. So, when x becomes 2, y becomes 2. So, this number must be what? 2. So, when x approaches 0 from its left, by this formula, I get values of f of x very close to what? 2. So, we may say that 2 is the limit of this function whenever x is approaching 0 from the left, which is called left hand limit. And we write this as limit of f of x as x tends to 0 minus, means x is approaching 0 from the left side of 0. And that limit is 2, means f of x, all these values are going towards what? So, their approach is 2. So, we say that 2 is the limit of f of x whenever x tends to what? 0 minus. Now, suppose x is coming from the opposite direction. That is, x is coming towards origin from its right. So, suppose x is coming in this direction. For all these values, you see that the height is increasing from right to left. And all these numbers are again approaching what? 2. So, we say that this time 2 is the right hand limit of the function f of x as x tends to what? 0. And we write this as limit of f of x as x tends to 0 plus is equal to 2. So, here we see that does not matter whether x is approaching 0 from its left or right. The function f of x itself is approaching what? The number 2. Therefore, 2 is the limit of this function. Now, if I make certain changes in the function, then again we will try to see the behavior of the function in this situation. So, suppose now let me consider f of x is equal to say 3 plus x. Whenever x is negative, equal to 2 minus x square whenever x is greater than or equal to 0. So instead of 2 plus x, I chose what? 3 plus x. So the graph would be little bit different. So when x is very close to 0, that time your direct limit is what? 3. So suppose this is 1, this is 2 and this is 3. The line is something like this. So this is your the line y equal to 3 plus x. And on the same side, it is approaching what? When x becomes 0, I get 2 minus 0 equal to 2. So for x equal to 0, here is another parabola. So this diagram, you see, because of change in this constant, this graph is lifted up and this is remained as it is. So in the neighborhood of x equal to 0, again, if x is taking values very close to 0 from its left, then limit of f of x as x tends to 0 minus, this time this point is what? 0, 3. So all the values are going towards what? The number 3. This is the height 3 to which all the values are approaching whenever x is very close to what? 0 from its left. So this is 3. Here if I find limit of f of x as x tends to 0 plus, so again you are coming in this direction and all these values are going towards what? The point 0, 2, means values of the function are approaching the number what? 2. So here the limit is 2. So this is the left hand limit. Whenever x tends to 0 minus is there, we call it left hand limit, means x approaches certain number from its left. And this is the right hand limit. So here left hand limit and right hand limit are same. Here left hand limit is different from right hand limit. So what to write? Whether the limit of this f of x is 3 or 2? This is a confusion. So we put the definition this way. So limit x tends to 0 of f of x is a fixed finite number. Then that number is the limit of the function. I said over here that fixed finite number, but the limit could be infinity also, that we'll talk afterwards. So limit of f of x as x tends to certain number, say 0, is fixed number like 2, then we say that here the limit exists and the limit is 2. But if the limits from the left and right are different, we say that limit does not exist. So when x is approaching 0 from the left, limit is 3. When x approaches 0 from the right, limit is 2. 2 is not equal to 3. Hence we say that in this case limit does not exist. So in the first example, limit does exist and it is equal to 2. In the second example, limit does not exist. And what we say about that? We just say limit does not exist. Sometimes it may happen in the following diagram. Suppose f of x I define as 2 plus x whenever x is less than 0 equal to 2 minus x square whenever x is greater than 0. And suppose for x equal to 0, I have the value of the function 1. So x equal to 0, f of x is what? 1. So if you try to plot the graph of this, almost the graph of this is same as what the graph of this, only here when I choose x equal to 0, I get the value of the function 2 only. So when I put x equal to 0 in the problem, I get f of 0 is 2 minus 0 equal to what? 2. So in this case, when x is 0, f of x I separately define as 1. Hence, let us draw the graph and check what is this. So this is your the line y equal to x plus 2. This is the parabola y equal to 2 minus x square. And for x equal to 0 separately, the value of the function is 1. Here, I cannot take the value 2. Limit of the function is 2, but the value of the function is here what? Different. So x cannot be 0, so I cannot use this formula to calculate the value of the function. I can use this formula to calculate the limit of the function. So limit of the function and value of the function, these are the two different things that we see over here. So here, when x is equal to 0, that time f of 0 is 1. And whenever x is not equal to 0, then in the neighborhood of x equal to 0, you can see approach of the function is 2. So 2 is the limit and here 1 is the value. So value is different from the limit. In this case, value and function both are same because equal to is included over here. So here, limit of f of x as x tends to 0 minus is 2, limit of f of x as x tends to 0 plus is 2, and the value of the function f of 0 is 1. When we talk about the limit, we are not bothered about the value of the function. Only we want to see whether whenever x is approaching 0 from left or right, as far as this example is concerned, f of x is approaching from both sides the same number or not. If f of x is approaching the same number from both sides, whenever x is approaching certain number, then we say that the limit exists. So even though here the value of the function is different, but the limits are same, we say that limit does exist. So limit is not related with what here the value of the function. Limit is nothing to do with the value of the function. So limit is the number to which function f of x approaches. So value of the function is nothing to do with the limit. Limit of the function is nothing to do with the value of the function. So both are different things. Please remember this. Now both would be considered in a certain case. That part of the chapter, that part is called what? The continuity, that we will see later on. So here, I define the limit of the function. Through these graphs, you understand what is the limit of the function. So whenever x is approaching certain number, where is f of x approaching from either side? If it is approaching to the same number, we say that limit exists, and limit is that number to which f of x is approached. So this way one can discuss the concept of what? Limits.